So I know I'm a little bit late on this one, but it is for good cause, as when this was first announced, Lightroom version 12, I believe mid-October or towards the end of October, roughly about 2 months ago, I just wasn't super excited about it. I played around with it a lot and I just felt like there wasn't anything that was a real kind of needle mover or game changer for my workflow for landscape photography. So it wasn't anything that got me real jazzed up, and it's really why I didn't make a video on it. I generally don't like to talk about things on this channel that I'm not excited about. So that's the short answer as to why I never made a video on the new Lightroom update. But after playing with it for a couple of months, there are two main things that I do find very, very beneficial. The things that kind of, I guess this kind of went over my head a little bit. I didn't pay much attention to them in the beginning, but I have found an incredibly useful use case for these two items, and I wanted to make a video on those specific items today. I'm not going to go over all of the updates with Lightroom version 12, just these two specific updates. And also Lightroom version 12.1 actually was just released, I believe, last week, which it's just a minor update, but there are some pretty cool organizational things in there that I think you'll like as well. So to jump right into it, this is an image I captured on my recent fall workshop in Colorado. I really liked the way this one came out. This was one of those images that wasn't a planned shot. I was actually driving to another destination and I saw this person taking this photograph and I was like, oh, how cool to capture a person capturing this scene unfolding standing in the middle of the street. So I hopped out of the car real quick, threw on a long lens and captured this. I only have about two versions of this photograph. The first one was blurry and out of focus. It was a handheld shot, but this one I think came out pretty good. But what I wanna do here is I'm gonna come up here to the masking section. And with Lightroom version 12, you'll notice that this looks a little bit different right through here. It's just an interface change or user interface update. So it's all a lot of cosmetic changes there, but functionally it all works the same. So, you know, I can come up here to sky and it's gonna detect the sky. It's gonna do a pretty good job there. And we can bring down the exposure a little bit. And you can see here, you might notice this. This is Lightroom version 12.1. This is that organizational update I was talking about. They now have all of these sections broken down. So you have tone, you have color, you have presence, you have detail, where before it was just one long list of all of the different sliders to choose from. So now it's organized, but that's not all. So not only is it cool just to stay a little bit more organized, but you can toggle each one of these sections on and off. So this, we're on the sky mask right now. We reduce the exposure and I can hit this little eyeball here and you can just turn off the sliders in this section, in the tone section that impact that mask. So if we come down here to presence and let's just say we crank up the clarity really high and we toggle this on and off. Now you can toggle off just the clarity. So anybody who watches my channel knows that I'm a big fan of on off switches and you can't have too many of them. And I think it's really cool to be able to toggle off individual sliders of a mask, as before all you could do is just toggle the mask on and off. So that's pretty cool. And if you want to see all the sections opened up at the same time, you can just right click here and hit or uncheck solo mode. And now you actually have the ability to open up all of these at one specific time like that. But I usually like to leave it in solo mode because I find that it just keeps things a little bit more organized. And yeah, so that's really the big update on Lightroom 12 version 12.1, easy for me to say, but I do think that is pretty cool. So what I'm gonna do here, now this is the thing that I think is really neat about the new update. So I'm gonna come up here to create new mask. And as you can see, the person standing here, that in my opinion is one of the most important aspects of this photograph, but she's kind of, you know, she's dark, you really can't see her, and she kind of gets a little bit lost in the overall photograph right there. So I'm going to come up here and let's go to select people. And in theory, this should work pretty well. So it's searching right now for people. And if I drop this down, you can see it's detecting people, and I'll take a second here. And you can see it says no people found. And obviously there is a person in the photograph, but she's so small in the frame that Lightroom really couldn't even pick her up. So this is the cool thing here. So I'm gonna come up here to create new mask, and I'm gonna come down here to objects. And what's cool about objects is that With objects, you can literally create a mask for anything and still use the AI engine inside of Lightroom to create that mask. So before, like, if you wanted to target the land, you would create a sky mask and then invert it to create the land. Or, you know, you just had to get creative with inverting masks and things like that. But now you have the ability to literally create a mask for anything. So I'm gonna come up here, and you have two ways to do it. So you can do it by just painting, and you can also do it by drawing a rectangle, so, or a square. So I'm just gonna select the square method here. I'm just gonna draw this rectangle right around her. And now you can see it's detecting objects, and look at how good of a mask that did right there. And it just took a matter of seconds. As you can imagine, if you tried to hand paint that in, that'd be very, very difficult. So now I can come up here to tone, and we can increase the exposure quite a bit to really make her come out. I'm gonna reduce the highlight some right through there. Maybe we even bring up the shadows a little bit. Let's come down to color, and let's increase the saturation of her green shirt and just really make her stand out here. I'm gonna increase this exposure just a little bit more to about right there. And I think something about like that looks pretty good. And if we toggle this on and off, so this is before and after, and now you can really see how the person pops off the screen. And that's a really important aspect of the photograph that you don't want to get lost. So I'm gonna come up here, let's rename it, and just name it person. And once again, before and after. So now what I wanna do is another important aspect of this photograph is the road, and I wanna make the road stand out a little bit more. So I'm gonna go back to the object selection. Well, let's try this just for experimenting purposes. Let's come up here to not select people, not background, obviously not sky. Let's try select subject. Now let's just see if Lightroom can figure out what the subject is. From my experience with outdoor photography or landscape photography specifically, Lightroom has a very difficult time determining what the subject is. It's not super clearly defined all the time. And in this scenario, it actually did a little bit better than I thought. It did select the road and the person, but it missed perhaps one of the most important aspects of the road. So I'm gonna come up here and I'm going to delete this mask. I'm gonna come back to create new mask, and let's do objects again. But this time I'm gonna select the brush, and I'm gonna increase the size, or you can increase and decrease the size of the brush by using the bracket keys right through here. Or you can just use the slider up here, it's up to you. So I'm gonna come over here and I'm just gonna start painting. I'm gonna paint all through here, and you don't have to get super, super specific with this, because once you have it selected, you can see that Lightroom's gonna go ahead and detect the objects, or what it thinks is the object. And it did a really good job. It missed a little bit right through here, but overall it clearly identified the road. So I'm gonna come up here to mask, and I'm gonna hit subtract. I'm gonna come down here to brush, and I am just going to paint away this area right through here that it missed. And I'm also going to make the brush really small. Maybe we'll just do a quick swipe on her leg that it accidentally grabbed as well. And I think that looks really good right there. And now I can come up here to exposure, and I can bring the exposure up quite a bit. And as I rock this back and forth, you can see how good of a job that did. So I'm gonna bring this up quite a bit, maybe even bring up the contrast some. We can come down here to color. We wanna boost the saturation just a little bit right through here. We come down to presence. And I think a common idea whenever you want to enhance a street or a road is to pump up the clarity or the texture, because it brings out some of that detail in the street. In this scenario, I already played around with it. When I bring up the texture and the clarity, it kind of makes the street look a little bit blotchy and just a little bit weird. So I actually thought it looked better applying negative texture and negative clarity, because it just kind of smoothed things out just a little bit through there. I'm gonna come back up here to tone and just bring down that exposure just a little bit. I don't need it to be quite that bright. And if I toggle the street on and off, so this is before and after, before and after, and let's come up here and let's name this street. So I think that the object selection tool is absolutely fantastic. Having two ways to do it, by drawing a rectangle or a square around your subject, or just painting the subject, I think that is an amazing add-on to the other Lightroom masks. So between the AI sky selection tool and person selection tool and subject, or I'm sorry, I already said subject, and background, there's a lot of power in Lightroom. And I know Lightroom gets a kind of a bad rap sometimes. I think a lot of people like to bash Lightroom because they say it's not as good as Photoshop. And no, it's not as good as Photoshop, but I don't believe it's meant to be as good as Photoshop. It's an incredible alternative for those that might not be comfortable using Photoshop, or maybe for those that don't want to have two subscriptions, a Lightroom subscription and a Photoshop subscription, and they just want to pick one or the other. And Lightroom's an amazing alternative. And one thing that I will give Lightroom kudos on, they are constantly putting out extremely meaningful and powerful updates, and they're moving along very quickly. Because if you look at when these masks, range masks, were first implemented to where they're at now, that's a pretty big progression in a relatively short amount of time. And every year it just gets more powerful and more powerful and more powerful. And I think that's fantastic. Now I'm gonna come up here to create new mask, and this hasn't changed much. Linear gradient hasn't changed at all, honestly. Just the interface, just the way it looks a little bit. I'm just gonna draw a linear gradient right through here. I just wanna darken down the exposure just a little bit, just to kind of create that dark to light transition there to add a little bit more depth to the overall photograph. And when I toggle this on and off, you can see what that has done. So that's before and after. So I'm gonna come up here and let's name this Street Dodge right there. And I'm gonna go ahead and close this down. And I'm gonna toggle all of these masks on and off just so you can see it. So that's before the masks and after the masks. Before the masks and after the masks. So I'm gonna close this down and minimize that. And there's also this button here too. So you can just hit that and that's gonna close it down as well and bring you back to the kind of like the main editing area. So up through here, you can see the little Band-Aid icon, and this is the Band-Aid icon for the clone and heal stamp tools. So you still have your healing kind of Band-Aid right through here, and then you also have your, I'm sorry, this is the healing icon that brings you down to this section. This right here is the clone tool, this right here is the heal tool, and then this right here is the content aware remove tool. And now this is what, one of the things that I always do inside of Photoshop is I remove items, because before this, removing items in Lightroom was pretty atrocious. The heal tool and heal tool and the clone tool, they did not work very well at all. Some scenarios you could get it to perform well, but for the most part, they really struggled. And I would always bring photos from Lightroom over to Photoshop to use the content aware fill. And this is a very similar type of tool. So I'm gonna come over here, and as you can see, there is the street signs. And I'm gonna toggle this entire edit on and off because there's a lot of stuff I removed. So this is before the entire edit. And you can see all of these things that I ended up removing with this content aware tool. And as I kind of toggle this on and off, you can see how good of a job it did. And it is super, super easy. So I'm just gonna come up here and I'm gonna select this content aware remove. You can adjust the size. You can adjust the overall opacity of the tool. And then we're just basically going to paint over whatever we want to remove. So I'm gonna remove this sign, of course, right through there, cover it all up, let go of your mouse. Lightroom is gonna analyze the area and it's gonna go ahead and make a selection of what it think is the best way to remove it or to cover it up. And it did a really, really good job. Now what's cool is if you don't think it did a good job and you want it to try again, you can come up here and hit refresh and Lightroom will go back and say, okay, let's pick a different area that Mark might enjoy a little bit better. And if that doesn't work either, if you read this, Command plus drag on the photo to select a custom source, I can hold down the Command key on the Mac and I can draw an area that I would like Lightroom to sample to create that content aware fill. So multiple different ways to do it, but in my experience, it does a pretty good job on the first time. Now, is it perfect? No. A content aware fill in Photoshop's not perfect either. But this, I believe, is much, much better than the heal and the clone tools in Lightroom previously. So I'm gonna come up here, over here, I should say, and let's remove this sign as well. Just kind of paint all the way around it to about right there. Give Lightroom a second to analyze it and make a selection. Let's see how it did. And that did a pretty good job there as well. So we can go ahead and close this down and I'll toggle the entire edit on and off. And you can really see all the different things that we removed. Even that sign way down there, I ended up removing that too. But that really, really cleaned up the overall photograph and it made it much, much easier and much more effective by using that content aware fill tool. So Those are the two things that I find incredibly, incredibly useful in the new Lightroom version 12.1 now. And I also find it incredibly beneficial how you're able to see all of these kind of more organized now, and how you can toggle each section on and off in your mask. And if you want to jump back to the global adjustments, you can just hit this button right here. So between the 12.0 update, the 12.1 update, I think those are some, there's a couple pretty meaningful tools that were applied to Lightroom. So I do hope that you find that information helpful to your specific photo editing workflow that you go through. If you have any questions, as always, please leave those in the comments section below, and I'll do my best to get back in touch with you as soon as possible. And if you enjoyed this week's video, if you could, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed already. Share the video with your friends, your family, or maybe your local photo club. If you enjoyed it that much, I would greatly appreciate it. And as always, I really do appreciate you checking out this week's video. And I will see you all next Wednesday. Bye.